Welcome to Bittersweet Science. I'm Jim Mellen. I'm a boxing coach, and I run my own boxing club, Wounded Deer Boxing Club, in Libertyville, Illinois. This program is called Bittersweet Science, which is also the title of a book I wrote with one of my boxing students on the subject of boxing, the sweet science. This program will cover topics within the sport of boxing. I hope you enjoy boxing with me. This first topic is going to be the age-old topic of an orthodox boxer as opposed to a southpaw boxer. Now, an orthodox boxer has the left foot and the left hand at the front, and the right foot and the right hand at the back. A southpaw boxer has the right foot and the right hand at the front, and the left foot and the left hand at the back. Traditionally, boxing trainers have wanted a natural right-hander to use the orthodox stance and a natural left-hander to use the southpaw stance. By natural, I mean if a person writes right-handed or left-handed, throws a baseball right-handed or left-handed, that type of thing. Because they believed that the power hand should be at the back to generate even more power from a straight backhand punch, the cross, as the hips turn. Now, Bruce Lee, the famous martial artist who loved boxing, and a lot of people don't know that, thought boxing was great, but that there was a flaw in the philosophy regarding this point. He believed that the power hand, the natural hand, should be at the front and not the back, because it would land the most often. The front hand lands the most often, and if it was the power hand, the natural hand, it would have enough power without getting the hips into it anyway. So he would have a left-hander convert to the orthodox stance and a right-hander convert to the southpaw stance. So those are two philosophies that were thrown out there, but by far the boxing philosophy is what is used almost entirely today. Beginning with that, I offer a third philosophy in that I believe the best stance in boxing is the southpaw stance, period. Here's why. The central nervous system, anatomically and physiologically, is a pathway that is trained best, especially in sports, by repetition. Now, it's a fact that most people are right-handed. Therefore, most boxers are right-handed. Therefore, most people that boxers spar with are right-handed. The left-handed person is able to practice with right-handed people all the time because there aren't many lefties. I know from my own experience that we hardly ever have any southpaws that come to me naturally anyways. I convert them all to southpaws because most people are right-handed, and because they use the boxing philosophy, they box from the orthodox stance. So, the orthodox stance, which is almost all boxers, continually get better against orthodox boxers because that's who they train with. Even camps that have a southpaw or two don't have them in every weight division. And it's considered a plus if you've got a southpaw in the camp, which a lot of them don't, to where when we take our southpaws to other camps, we always do well because they don't have southpaws to work against. Now, the left-hander, the southpaw, on the other hand, is always practicing against orthodox or right-handed boxers. So, basically, orthodox boxers get better against orthodox boxers because that's usually all they have, and southpaw boxers get better against orthodox boxers because they usually spar against orthodox boxers. So what it comes down to is orthodox gets better against orthodox and southpaw gets better at orthodox. But orthodox does not get better at southpaw. So when an orthodox boxer faces a southpaw boxer, the southpaw boxer has the advantage. And that's, of course, with everything else being equal. What I do with my boxers, so they have the advantage by working with orthodox boxers, I have my boxers learn on both sides. So if, for another reason, I've got orthodox boxers to spar with my southpaw boxers, but then again, it's also good to learn from both sides anyways. And then they, of course, have the advantage that most other clubs don't get much practice against southpaw boxers. So the best stance, in my opinion, is the southpaw stance. You can take it or leave it. I'm Jim Mellen, and I hope you've enjoyed boxing with me.